This video takes a look at how to learn to use the SPC for Excel software. It's simple to use, but like anything else, it usually helps to have a few steps to get started. One way you can do it is to watch videos for the various techniques on our website, Statistical Tools SPC for Excel. So there we'll have videos of how you make a frequency Pareto diagram or a basic histogram or a control chart, non-normal capability, distribution fitting. Most of the features here have a video associated with them, so you can watch from there. If you rather learn by doing, we have some example data files that you can use with the help files. The example data files are stored under Documents, SPC for MS Excel, in a folder called V5 Example Data Files, and there you'll find workbooks that contain information for attributes data or variables data or Pareto or histogram, and you can use those to help learn how to use the SPC for Excel software, because these data files follow right along with the SPC for help. The SPC help gives you step-by-step instructions in how to construct each of these techniques, and they're based on the data files that are stored under your Documents folder. And the other thing you can do is contact us for help. Simply send us an email, support@spcforexcel.com. Tell us what your problem is. If we need to set up a web meeting or something to help you get started, we'll be glad to do it. Now let's take a look at how these techniques work to learn the SPC for Excel software. The first way we're going to look at is using the videos on our website. So what you do is you simply go to our homepage, spcforexcel.com, and you'll see SPC software next to the home tab, and below it are statistical tools in SPC for Excel. You select that. This takes you to a page that lists all our statistical tools that we have, and each of the tools are linked to a page of their own. For example, Pareto diagrams, histogram, control charts, process capability, gauge R&R, etc. So suppose you want to see how to make a process capability chart. So you select process capability, and it takes us to the process capability page. And here on the process capability page, you will see that there is a video that shows how to create a process capability chart using the SPC for Excel software. You simply select play. I have it muted in this case, but of course you'll have sound, and it will walk through and it will show you the steps in creating a process capability chart. We also have it for the non-normal process capability analysis. But that's simply what you do. You go to the statistical tools in the SPC for Excel, select which tool you want to see, how to create, and it'll have a video showing you how to do that. The second way to learn the SPC for Excel software package is to make use of the example data that came along with the help files. The help files give you the step-by-step instructions for doing things. The example data will be included in your Documents folder under a folder called SPC for MS Excel in a folder that says V5 Example Data. And you'll have a number of different workbooks. For example, this first workbook is attribute control charts data. So if you're going to make an attribute control chart, this is where the data. Here's cause and effect data. What this does is it goes along with the SPC for Excel ribbon. So, for example, suppose we open the attributes control chart and we want to make a C chart. So we go to the C chart page. And what it has is it has the data entered already. And it says to use these data to make a C chart, you simply select the data. Then you select attribute and you select C chart and you select OK, and then all you have to do is to actually fill in the name of the chart. So we'll just call it my C chart, and you select OK, and you've created your C chart already. But to help you along with that, of course, in the SPC for Excel are help files. Okay, and you go to help files, and what you'll see is over here you'll see all the help files that we have, and it's based along the SPC for Excel ribbon. So it starts with Pareto charts, histogram, then goes to control charts, and here's the C chart that we're working on. So you come in, and what the C chart does, it gives you a little bit about the C chart, then it gives you the steps, how you enter the data, how do you create a new chart, what the options are for the C chart, how do you update the chart, how do you change the options. And then also, of course, you have the ability to have a whole bunch of control chart actions which are covered here, including splitting the control limits, removing points from calculations, adding comments. So the help files give you the step-by-step instructions for doing that. So that's another way of learning how to do the SPC for Excel software package. Third way to learn SPC is to simply send us your questions. If you have a question, send it to support@spcforexcel.com. Simply let us know what you need. You can simply say, hello, how do you split control limits? And what we will do then is we will respond and tell you how to do that. So So this is a third way to do it, and if need be, we'll be happy to set up a web meeting to show you how to use the software. So, three quick, easy ways to learn how to use the SPC for Excel software. Watch our videos online, Statistical Tools, SPC for Excel. Look at the example data files stored under Documents and the help files that go along to get hands-on experience, or contact us for help. Support at SPC for Excel. We'd be glad to help you in any way we can to make you a successful user of the SPC for Excel software. Thank you.